I have nothing but good news moving forward. But if you make it to the end, you'll understand why everyone gets wiped out. But if you have ADHD like me, this will be one of the best videos you will watch ever on the interwebs. And if you leave the video halfway through, I guess hashtag FOMO gang. If you make it to the very end, you're going to make so much more money than those kids in class, right? Like dip out halfway through. You're like, you missed the end of the movie. And we have some earnings reports. We have good news and we have some bad news. But again, that's only if you make it to the very end. And inflation. Uh-oh, SpaghettiOs and inflation on my course too. Also, some more good news. You have a few days left until I bump the price up. Inflation, I know, from 300 to 400 on this video. You see my trading strategies and indicators, and it's kind of a lot. I can't do it all in, well, it takes me many videos. Actually, I will continue filming that course forever and ever until I pass. Take advantage of the 300 rather than the 400 that will be going up this week. And know this, as an investor and a trader, we get to, you get to, because you are an investor, you're a trader, and you're a business owner. Because you've been with me long enough, you know, you start a business, you trade equities, inflation is on your side. And as an employee, inflation is not on your side, right? That is not good. You have a job. Not to say that jobs are bad. Jobs are good. I have a job. Well, I don't consider, it's more so a hobby. When I teach college classes or teaching high school business, it's just a hobby. I can stop doing it at any point. Isn't that nice? That's where you want to be, that you can stop doing said job at any point and doesn't even affect your income. If I stop teaching, wouldn't even notice it, because it's your businesses that should generate the income. And then you could do things that you want as hobbies. Like you give people carts at Walmart. But oh my gosh, that was just an ADHD moment. I am sorry. You're here before Monday, so I can tell you what is going to happen. I take out my crystal balls and I'm going to tell you what will happen with the stock market so you can take advantage of this, so you can ride this pony. And I apologize if this is not how you ride a pony when I was a kid. Dang it, another eight. Sorry, I used to have a little Shetland pony. Thing would take me up in the hills, roll me, and then go back home. But really quick, the first thing I wanted to cover is this guy right here, right? Interest rates. I want to cover bond yields. Bond yields are going up, and it seems like the markets are priced in. They're like, we're okay with that. If you're okay with that, kind sir, I am okay with that. What I mean by that is markets are forward-looking. They look to the future. And they say, I see interest rates rising. Now this, I mean, I can go way back. I believe, even though you're seeing this little uptake. I started to say uptake. Did you hear that? And then I changed it to uptake. Good job, brain. That was, we'll make sure we don't edit that one out. We will just stay a complete idiot for, see this, we've been in this channel since, going back to 1985. And rates go down and down and down. So, you know, we may come up to the, 2% range. Everyone will say, nope, the market will crash, but looks like it's okay. Maybe I'll wait till the end to show you that. But, bond yields, big picture, dropping. And also when it comes to inflation, I see this all the time. Fed go burr, right? All this just hit every, no, it's, ugh. I'm sorry. They create Chucky when it comes to inflation, but I'll tell you what they are doing. They're creating a lot of Chuck E. Cheese tokens that are, it's still in the system. It has not entered the real economy yet. When that happens, woo, super inflation. And as you know, just want to say thank you. All those stimmies that are going out, it's not really doing anything. The money's not moving around. You guys are paying off debt. Like, what are you doing? You keep it in the, I'm just going to save it. Just keep it in there. Keep it in the banking system. So it's not hitting the real economy. So we're not seeing the inflation like we actually should be. You're seeing it, but not like you really, really should be seeing it. Also, I want to show you that we are in a bull market. Remember, I always trade on the 200. So even though it may come across doom and gloom, you know my trading strategies. Swing trader number one, above that 200. Don't care. The Dow, the S&P 500, the NASDAQ, what I'm showing right now, semiconductor, could be a good frame of reference of where we are going and how are we going to weather this market. Semiconductors, technology. We're in an age of technology. So let's see. Let's see where we're at and where we're going. And why don't we trade now? Click. There we go. There is the chart, the magical chart for you. You should be paper trading. So you'd click right here. I'll also leave a here, just to let you know, this is called TradingView. There should be a link in the description for TradingView. If it is not, well, then it's not. But it's kind of cool because you guys should be. Now, this is when I say, oh, hey, I can click connect. This is not financial advice. Don't listen to me. Just this is all paper trading. That's all I do. But if you want to also know, you're like, hey, where do you, how do you trade? Mobile, love Webull. Bust out my phone. I'm with, you know, I don't want to sit on a screen 24/7 and like, blip, click. Blap, done. I do actually use TradeStation when I am using TradingView. So it is Webull. Oh, link in the description if you want. I believe it's a couple free stocks. Could be wrong, but good little way to start your trading. So we're going to look at semiconductor, and then we'll look at the Dow, the DIA, or however you guys want to trade it. Right here, this, we entered a bull market. That's my line. That's the 200. Bull market from there. See how it just bounces right off. Bouncy, 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 bouncy. And then there, that was 2018. We entered a bear market for a little bit. And then we pulled out, right? We pulled out right there. That's 2019, 2020. Hey, bull market. Safe zone. Everyone is safe. Everyone is safe. We tested it right there. And then you guys knew this right here. That is where we entered a bear market. We left it, and I actually left the market. I tried to get out of everything. And as proof, I found this because we're moving. I'm like, oh gosh, I could show everyone this. This is here. That's my signature too, if you ever need it. January 3rd, 2020. That's my 403B program that I have been investing in the S&P 500 for over 20 years. Bond hold over 20 years. And I begged them in January. I said, can I please like move it? can I move it to cash? They're like, sorry, sir, we cannot do that with the 403B. You have to quit. And I'm like, I think it might be a good idea. I quit. And then I had to watch my account go down and down and down. And then it went up and up and up. I had it too. I had it in the bag. It's almost like real estate, you know, when you're like, I think this could be, real estate gives you time though. Stocks, you know, elevator and escalator. It's always an escalator up, elevator down. So you got to be quick on the trigger finger. But I have been ever since, and I preached on that channel right there, bull market. He's safe. And I wish all these accounts were as easy as BlockFi that gives you 8 points. Now check this out. Look at this. See, in my head, I'm like, can I move all this over to a stable coin and still get almost 9% interest? Is that, we'll just leave it there. Is that all right? Please, please, please let DeFi start to take place, because this whole like banking system is just a fluster cluck. Also, I will leave a link in the description for BlockFi. Now, I would never recommend, it better be just a small portion. Do not go FOMO with your crypto, your Bitcoins, and your XRPs, and your little doji coin, your little doggy coins that are running around that don't secure the network. And when that thing goes, come on, guys. Bitcoin's secured network has been forever and ever, probably one of the best secured networks, never been hacked. Well, until it does, Johnny Bravo. Okay, you win. But I think they give you $250 if you open it with a certain amount. But for me, I just love it. I'm like, oh, move it over there. Oh, still get almost 9%. Whoo. Shaking it off. But even in the market, if you guys love inflation, the Dow, everything, it's like, yay, inflation for the rich, right? That's just, sorry, great K-shaped recovery. Boy, was that just not like in everyone's faces? Oof, anyone get mad about that at all? But you took advantage of it, did you not? Do we want to trade now, or do we want to go full featured chart in this bull market for the Dow Jones Industrial Average? I am currently on the week. And what I want to do is just show you, in regards to the RSI, how many times we've been in these oversold conditions and what happens. What kind of gains for what period of time do we get to reap this benefits? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We have 6 times. And I mean, I could do the chart that goes back to like 1890. I mean, there's There's very few times that you see, and I'm kind of in the way, but just trust me, there's a big, here, see that? Bingo, bango. These market conditions are just primed for yay. And if we were just to go back to the last time we had these oversold conditions on the RSI, we would be looking at, this was our last oversold down here. I'm missing the bottom. I'm sorry, kids, I tried. I couldn't get it. If you were just to buy at the bottom and then resell at the bottom, the amount of gains, I mean, just this is the lowest of lows. You're up 175%. That's like worst case scenario. Okay, I think I will take it. And if I would measure from the bottom of the crash, right, till now, it's 83%. You still got 100% left. And also, I don't really trade on the weekly. I'm not that. I got some life still left in me, in these bones. Since we entered out, isn't that interesting? So interesting. The 200-day moving average. They're like chartists, those stupid idiots. Why would you even listen to that Johnny Bravo? What does he know? Well, I don't, but the charts seem to tell you a story, right? When we full candle bounce exactly off the 200-day moving average, maybe it's a good time to learn how to become a swing trader. But yeah, since you've been in this bull market right here, we're going to say you entered out of it. Boom, look at that candle, that big old fat candle right above that. We're going to measure it there when we come up. I cannot see it. I hope you guys can see it. Maybe if I hide, what do I need to do? Can I move this? See, then it goes away. I am so upset. Do you see this? Do you see my upset face right now? Oh, it goes. Wait, where can I move it? No, it goes up there. 30% since we came out of that bull market. You could have caught it right there too, right off the 200. Or just take it on the swing. And for those of you that trade without these indicators, I just want to congratulate you. Just go with your gut. Oh my gosh, I would be dead in the water. All right, so let's do this. Let's turn one on and go, oh, okay, smooth and high. Kanashi says, let's enter right about there, right? We got a little red. We got some green showing. But just in case you want to be a little trigger finger early, your buy candle one right there. There it is. That is very helpful for me. Maybe not for you because you just go with your gut and you just know. Or maybe you just read news articles. You flip on Market Watch or CNBC or MSNBC or AOL, right? AOL Instant Messenger. Weekend reads a warning. Ooh, that wasn't supposed to be here. A warning for a record high stock market. Shoot, I should have put that last or removed it. This is just good news right now. Okay. You're gonna have to wait for this one. Oh, this is even worse. Bitcoin's threat. Ooh, did you guys know? You guys know that Bitcoin might be a threat? What? What is this story? Peter Thiel? Oh, I did talk about that Chinese financial weapon against the U.S. What? I thought. Aren't they already a threat? Isn't that interesting? How they got us? We're just consumers. They're the manufacturer. We just consume. The only reason why we are what we are is because of this, the almighty dollar, until we lose that. Wow. China, it's like a chess game, right? And checkmate. See, kids, you don't need to go to war with like ships and all those kind of things. It's right here. And you see, they've been adopting, now they adopted the whole yuan. And it's the digital on the phone, right? Goes right on their phone. They're like, oh my gosh, I love this. And then I have the social score. And if I'm really good, I get my stimmy checks and woo. And then I could pay. And then all of a sudden they notice, oh, wait, there's more control where it limits when you can buy. And then it disappears. My money's gone. So I got to spend it right now. But that was a bad story. I don't know how I snuck that one in there. Freudian slip got you in there. Earnings season is about to get underway. This is exciting. And that could be a positive catalyst for stocks. Well, Patty Doom, I would say yes. These earnings, because people are like, oh my gosh, We're all going to rush in.
And just like me, I'm like, I run with those lemmings, man. You know, they're all, woo, lemmings. And then they fall off a cliff, right? No, I pull that ripcord, boom, parachute. I actually don't. I don't even jump off the cliff with them. I'm like, let's go, yeah, to the moon. And then I start walking down the hill. And the analysts are going to go crazy for what is about to happen. Stock bulls bet it all on earnings rather than looking at charts. And analysts say that, I guess you guys aren't seeing what's coming. S&P 500 bakes in profits. Coming before 2023. You guys are already over there? History shows faith in events that far out is often misguided. And I say trust in those analysts. They will not lead you wrong. The banksters, they got your back. The YouTubers that are like, we got a double banger here. Because that's what an analyst says. That is just, they read off of stories and they're like, triple banger, quadruple banger, because, you know, Kathy Wood, which, you know, she's amazing. Love you, Kathy. But I've thrown out fundamentals a long time ago, 2008, 2009, trying to teach my high school kids a PE ratio. And they're like, Mr. Bravo, everything that you're saying is incorrect. And then I had to go back because I'm a dude that can change. Can you believe that? I actually have the ability to change. And I started looking at it. And I'm like, okay, I'm doing this all wrong. And now I kind of take fundamentals. I go, okay, can Tesla reach a $3 trillion market cap? Well, I don't know. I don't think so, but okay. This is cool. Here we go. Let's pull back. Look at the macro here. Inflows, two stocks past 5 months. Inflows past 12 years over there. That I can only go so far. Right? See, then my finger gets cut off. It's like, it's a sad day when you lose your... I can't look at that screen and then try to figure out where I'm going. Global equity flows. These are billions. $452 billion past five months. This is globally. $569 billion. It's been a good 5 months. Now, back to the markets. We had some... Oh, what do we got? Credit Suisse. Titan's head fund. Sorry, ADHD. You know how we had some beatdowns, and this is what I like, you know, when they get caught double, triple leveraging on everything, cause that's just how greed is. They're like, wow, if I can make $1 million doing this, can I make $100 million? If I leverage 100 times, Viacom, Discovery, Farfetch, let's take a look, because my wife actually, went out drinking one night and I saw a bill from that. She actually went out drinking with my daughter. Hmm. And I saw this big bill on the on my phone the next day, and I quickly clicked refund. But what I did leave out of that story is I was there too. And also, lesson number 97 is never shop when you're drinking out at a Mecca. I was like, what? What did we buy? Oh my gosh! So I want to look at this company that we seem to have purchased from, and one thing that stands out like a sore thumb, right? Do you see that? The 200-day moving average. What a shocker, right? Bounces right off of it. Hmm. So interesting. Maybe if you understood charts, you would understand this stuff. And maybe if you looked right up here, when would be a good time to exit? You see, first red bar, time to get out. We can turn on some other indicators to tell you when. Now, do you see? Are we coming up on a possible good time to get in? And I will turn on one more indicator for you. That would be the 9. And I know sometimes, I just want to let you know, my buy-sell indicators are a little premature, but it's just kind of that heads up. Are you ready? The Heikinashi yet, but I like it. I'll tell you what I like. What I really, really like, isn't that sad? I give you all of this stuff on this channel for free. You don't even need to take, well, I would, the course, right? Facebook group, Discord, me reaching out, things like that. Let me grab an arrow. See this one candle close, full close above that nine, right? Ooh, that is one really bad. I tried. Okay. I tried to do an arrow. TradingView let me down with that said arrow. So let me get rid of everything and give you one more arrow. my entry would have been there. Now, you see, a lot of times you can't all have your kits in the caboodles. You had your one buy indicator here telling you, eh, and that's still kind of holding. Did tell you to get out. You had a close, you had a candle close, like, yeah, full candle, like there. I'd be like, bye, bye bye, I'm out. And then, yeah, possible re-entry. I mean, if you want there, but if you kind of want to wait for the green to show up, you may be buying it at about $52 a share. Either way, any way you look at it, with everything from what is going to be taking place over the next year to 2 years, I think we got some runs, and not the kind of runs that you want. Like back in third grade, when I thought it was a fart, it turned out to be a shark. And it's always nice to be able to air my most embarrassing moment to 120,000 of you. So there you go. Anticlimactic story. Let's just say my dating scene was very limited for probably 20 years after that. And now for the bad news. Well, not yet, just yet. One of my favorite blogs, Real Investment Advice. They do have a YouTube channel. They do have a podcast, pretty good. Their buy indicator flashed on the S&P 500. That was back in March. A buy. Now we have a breakout. We scroll on down here. We got the Bollinger Bands. Like, what are these new words that you're using? Bollinger Bands. We actually broke out of that trend. Look at that trend. See the trend line? Whoop, boop, boop. We broke above it on the S&P 500. Guess that means good, right? Is that good when we break out? Actually, what I need to do is I need to make this a little bigger. Right, there. You can see that more gooder now. Perfect. That is perfect. Now, what we would like to do is retest that. If we can retest that, that's even better. But I'll definitely take a breakout. But with good news and bad news, expect a correction midsummer to be somewhere between 5 to 10%. Investors are all in. All in. And what happens after that said rip? Well, you have a crash. Look. Way above, 1974. What was I doing? 1974. Probably, picking up chicks. 74. Eh, not yet. 87, yes. Crash of 87. But look at the price to annual sales. Let me grab a little arrow here. Let me turn my arrow black. Big, black, and that's kind of thin. The dot-com, look, price to annual sales. Look at the distance that we are. No, financial crisis. Look at that. Look at the distance, price to sales. Eh, look where we're at now. This is the mother of all bubbles. Oh my gosh. In the end, again, two? Well, that means you just dislike this video, so you can't do it twice. But in the end, I'm excited. Maybe I could start moving this channel where it's like 80, 90, wouldn't just 100% this is exciting rather than any like, hey, look out. I know we're on top of the car. It is going 120 miles an hour. This is fun. But I'm looking at Barbara down there and she has her foot on the brake pedal. But I think it's safe. It's safe to be that way, right? That's just me. Risk allocation. You don't want to, go all in. But thanks for hanging out to the very end. And I'll see you tomorrow.